Welcome back to Tip Top Trading, where everyone seems a bit flustered.
And we really need the best biscuits there are.
Yes, and I've made sure there's tea and coffee.
And the carpets?
Huh?
Have they been cleaned?
Don't panic, Paul. All taken care of.
You see, the big boss from America, Mr. Socrates, is in town, and everything must be just right. What's he like, Anna?
Well, so far, he seems okay. A bit bossy, quite short, and a bit smelly.
Well, he did just fly in from the States. But you booked him into a good hotel, so hopefully he's had a chance to clean up.
I hope so. Oh, I had better get that. Hello? Hello, Mr. Socrates. Did you sleep well? Oh, I see. I don't know. Tom said it was 5-star. Well, okay, good. Oh, he's hung up.
Everything okay, Anna? You look a bit pale.
It was Mr. Socrates. He's not happy.
Golly gosh, oh dear. What's the matter?
It's his hotel room. He doesn't like it. The bed's too soft, too small, and it's a single room, not a twin room.
Oh yes, he likes to have two beds in the room for some reason.
But Tom said he only likes a single bed in the room.
Really? Oh no, he insists on a twin. Something to do with business partners, he says. Anything else?
Yes, he says he wanted freshly squeezed orange juice for breakfast. Not the stuff out of a carton.
Anything else? A view of Mount Everest, perhaps?
Yes, thank you, Denise. Well, we really must sort this out. We can't afford to upset Mr. Socrates. Now, Anna, you chose this hotel. I really think you need to sort out this mess.
It was Tom's suggestion.
Just sort it quickly. Oh, golly gosh, golly gosh.
Uh-oh, Anna. Time to do some complaining. What are you going to say?
Oh, I don't know. I'm not very good at complaining.
Well, Anna, keep your cool and politely tell the hotel why you're not happy. You could say, I'm very disappointed with your service. The standard of service is not good enough. The room I booked did not meet my expectations. Good luck, Anna.
Okay, here goes.
Hello, Royal Imperial Hotel.
Hello, I want to complain.
Really? About what exactly?
Your hotel. Well, I mean, a room I booked for my boss. Room 101. I'm very disappointed with your service.
And why is that then?
Well, the room isn't like the one I booked. It's just not good enough.
Let's have a look at that booking. Well, your boss got a bed and a breakfast too. A continental breakfast, in fact.
But the room just didn't meet his expectations. Hello?
Give me the phone, Anna. I'll deal with this. Now, hello, Miss...
Miss Fit?
Miss Fit? This is the officers... I mean the manager here. This isn't good enough. My colleague has made it quite clear that the room did not meet our requirements, and I would like you to resolve this matter as quickly as possible, or I will have to cancel our reservation.
Sadly, we have no other twin rooms available, and anyway...
All right. I'd like to speak to your manager, please. Really?
Good old Denise. I can tell she's done this before. But will talking to the manager really sort things out? Let's remind ourselves of some of the phrases you can use when you need to complain.
I'm very disappointed with your service. The standard of service is not good enough. The room I booked did not meet my expectations.
And to get things sorted, you could say...
I would like this matter resolved as quickly as possible.
Or...
I would like to cancel my reservation and get a full refund.
Let's see if Denise has sorted things out.
So, have you managed to sort out Mr. Socrates?
Oh, yes. Anna's got him a new room.
Thanks, Anna. I'll let him know. And what about the orange juice?
Freshly squeezed every morning.
Oh, golly gosh. That reminds me, we need some here in the office. He's going to be here any minute, and he says he's got some important news for us.